Welcome to the final video in the Collecting Sensor Data series. In this last video, we are going to send the captured sensor data to the web server. Once the data is stored on the web server, the next step towards the digital twin of your strawberry can be taken. The data will be sent to the web server using the JSON format. Before sending the data to the web server, we have to create a unique ID for each of the high-growth sensor birds that partake in the course. This can be achieved automatically by using the built-in MAC address of the microcontroller on the high-growth board. This function will return the chip ID. Next to a unique ID, we also like to store the time the data was captured. For this, we can use an NTP server. NTP stands for Network Time Protocol, and it's a networking protocol for clock synchronization between computer systems. In other words, it is used to synchronize computer clock times in a network. The function I use here returns the time in epoch time, which is the number of seconds that has elapsed since January 1st, 1970. On the web server, this epoch time will be translated to human-readable time. But for this function to work, the high-growth sensor should be connected to the internet. So that will be the next step. To connect your high-growth sensor board to the internet, we first need to create some variables to store your SSID and password. If you're copying this code, don't forget to replace the stars with your own credentials. The third line is for getting the time. We will request the time from pool.ntp.org, which is a cluster of time servers that anyone can use to request the time. Second, we create a function that initializes the Wi-Fi connection. Inside this own function, we make calls to functions mode and begin of the Wi-Fi library. I also added some print commands for feedback. The while loop runs until the high-growth sensor board is connected to the local network. Each iteration, it will print a dot until it is connected to the local network. When you have finished this function, it would be a good moment to test your code by uploading it to the high-growth sensor board. As announced, we will be sending the data from the high-growth sensor to the web server in JSON format. This function creates a JSON object, which consists of key value pairs for each of the data elements that will be sent. Now that the data is ready, let's have a look at how to actually send it to the server. The send data function starts with creating variables to make sure the data is being sent to the right location. We use string ID and string server name for this. Third line is used to create an interval between sending data. The milli function returns the number of milliseconds passed since the microcontroller board began running the current program. This number, millis, will overflow, go back to zero, after approximately 50 days. The last time variable gets updated each time at the end of this code block. If we now look at the first if statement, or the condition, then we see that it checks whether the time that has passed since the last time data was sent is larger than a predefined time. In the example code, I set the timer delay to about 3 seconds. This is rather short, because values will most likely not change that much in a short time, but we choose it to populate our database. I encourage you to pick a longer period between sending data. With the send data function being finished, we are nearly done with our code, but we need to add two more lines to our setup function. We need to make a call to our function that initializes the Wi-Fi, init Wi-Fi, and we also need to make a call to config time, which is part of the time library. This enables us to collect the current epoch time. The last function that needs to be changed is a loop function. All that this function has to do is make a call to the sendData function we created just before. When we now upload the program to the high-growth sensor board, the collected data will be sent to the Strawberry Field web server. You probably now want to validate if your sensor board is actually sending data to the server. You can do this by entering the server address in your browser. Replace the ID by the ID of your own sensor board. You should get a list of JSON objects with the key value pairs. You can also open the dashboard in your browser, strawberryfields.fhict.nl, and then on the right, search for your sensor ID, and it will display the current values of your sensor. So, this is it. We're finished. I hope you enjoyed this video series. By now, you should have a fully programmed hygro sensor. If you want, you can find the code on the repository that goes along with this course.